question.
Yes.
Which is the right age to do business, and does business depend on experience?
Okay, there is no right age for business, but I would obviously say is that always start a business part time. Right, always start a business part time in the sense what I tell people is that is when you're studying, if you have a business idea, start. The problem with most of the people is they want to study and enjoy. They want to study and they want to enjoy. That is where most of the problem with the world is. Study, free time, work on your dreams, work on your passion. Festival holidays, work on your passion. Weekends, work on your passion. Work on the business which you have. Work, work, work. Test it. Okay? Then maybe sometimes you might have to get a job. Because what happens is when you have a business idea, you go and ask investors to invest money into it, you will lose 30 to 40% of your business to them. So it's much more smarter to delay the business and go and start working and make that money and invest it in your business so that you own 100% of your business. So while you're working for 3-4 years, making the money, business plan is all set, you know how organizations work. Because when you work, you get the business experience. So that time when you work in the business, you got to go and search and find out how HR is working, how finance is working. I am in this job to learn how to run a business and not to do my job. So do your job, learn how the business runs, see if I can apply it into my business. Slowly, slowly, you will start this part-time business and your business income is going to be double of what you are going to make in your salary. That is the time you drop job and go for your business. Did that make sense?
Yes, sir. Is technical knowledge important for a business? For example, I want to do a bioinformatics business. Yeah. So is the technical knowledge more important or my marketing knowledge?
Every business has a product and a marketing side of things. Either you appoint someone who can do the technical side of things and you focus on marketing, or do you focus on the marketing? You put someone else focusing on the marketing and you put on to the technical side of things. But then if you're getting into the business, you need to have an overview of both the ideas. Because sometimes what happens is that if you don't have any idea of bio, whatever you're doing, you appoint a person who also have no any idea, you will pay him a lot of money, your business, all revenue will go to him, he'll take the money and he will go. So whatever your business you're getting in, whoever is leading the show should have both technical information and both marketing overview, so that you can at least find out the general errors which they are making or you are making. See, for example, these talk sessions, right? I'm already working. I can obviously convert this talking and positive spreading into a business anytime, but I will never do it. That's the promise I've given to the world, right? After 10 years, you ask me for a session, it'll be always done free of charge. And that is how I'm going to do for the rest of my life. But I can obviously convert this into a business anytime and mint enough money which I want to mint. But then it is just giving back to the community. I can't do it. But why? I'm still working. I can take the risk. Got it?
Yes, sir.
That's it. My job is done for today. Muskan, you're done? Exhausted with questions? Anything you want, you know, clear the doubt. See, now Yogi Loganushi had a beautiful question. So ask these doubts to clarify that so you have a very good understanding as to what it's all about, right? Because I don't mind talking until Kavita ma'am says stop. I will go on talking until she says stop, or I will continue until you keep asking the question.
I will not say stop, but please have water at least. It's been 2 hours now. You're just keep on talking.
I'm all good. Go ahead. Questions?